mom always thought I was a freak because all I ever wanted to do was play Warcraft 2, watch Star Wars, play on my Dreamcast, and other nerd-related activities such as dressing up like a woodland elf and taking pictures in my friend's backyard, which I never did. Yet, as a teenage girl, I despised normal teenage girl things, such as talking on the phone, chick flicks, the OC, going to Jamba Juice, the color pink, ugh. Oh wait, charm bracelets, the Hello Kitty cult, prom, God help me, and most of all, shopping. Ugh. While I'm still not a very big fan of shopping because malls are little subsidiaries of hell, I find comfort in buying mass amounts of one thing. I swear I have a point here. To celebrate my obsession with both shoes and gaming, I bring you top 5 craziest video game footwear. Number 5, Ayumi from X-Blades. Girl, what you be wearing on your feet? I wish I could explain these boots to you, but I can't. For a girl who's wearing little more than a strapless shelf bra and a thong made out of mid-grade 2-ply, those are some big-ass stupid combat boots. They look like they could be snowboarding boots from Xenon Girl of the 21st Century. Am I the only one who remembers that movie with Raven and the girl who does soap operas now? Honestly, I couldn't even finish X-Blades because Ayumi annoyed the ever-loving sh** out of me. And these boots, frankly, just make her more irritating. Now I'm getting angsty, we should move on. Number 4, the boots of blinding speed in Oblivion. No, wait, Morrowind. You guys would have torn me apart about that. In case you aren't familiar with these boots, they are pretty much exactly what the name implies. You'll be able to run very, 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 very fast, but you will also be blind. Sure, you'll be knocking over trees with your face, but you'll be doing it quickly. You know, I really like the concept of giving gamers something extremely useful with a terrible downside. I think we should do that more often. Maybe a Ferrari in Forza that has no brakes. Or a Pokemon that cannot take damage but can only use the splash attack. Or how about a killer robot that will do whatever you want but will turn on you at any given moment. My cat's like that. Number 3, Robin's magnetic boots from Lego Batman. Tell you the sheer amount of expletives that spewed forth from my glossed lips as I had to clomp around in these loud, slow, obnoxious boots. I can't possibly think of a more unstealthy, inefficient way of doing anything than to put magnetic clomping boots on Robin, who last I checked was already pretty acrobatic and didn't have a problem getting up to places without being magnetic. Here, co-op partner, let's just sit here for the next 10 minutes as I scale this building. Clomp, 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 clomp. Number 2, Blood Rain. This feisty redhead is obviously sexy, but she's got a dangerous, pointy secret. The heels of her boots? Death spikes! She could stab out an eyeball simply by kicking. Now, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little bit bitter about this concept, since I swear I came up with this idea first. Except my concept was less spike and more hidden switchblade. But those had to go and become all illegal. The closest the average person can come to foot spikes are maybe soccer cleats? But those seem significantly less hardcore, and soccer is lame. So, show some respect for Blood Rain because she is, in fact, a stabby-footed ass-whomper. And that should have been the description on the back of the game case. Bam! Where's my money, bitch? And my predictable number one pick for the most ridiculous footwear in video games has to be the one and only Bayonetta. Bayonetta's fighting style and finishing moves are both elegant and completely absurd. But her shoes? Hey, I am totally okay with the absurdity of those. They're guns! Her shoes are guns! They shoot people! Her shoes can't shoot people! I want these so bad, I even asked my redneck mother if I could strap two of her pistols to my feet one time, But she mumbled something about that being a bad idea. Oh, so I can wear soccer cleats, but I can't strap projectile weapons to my feet? Double standard, Mom. Well, that's it for this edition of Top 5. I hope I inspired you to spend lots of money on shoes that you will never wear. I'm looking at you, strappy leopard print 4-inchers. Until next time, I'm Lisa Foyle. Soccer is lame.